Today I am going to talk about the electric cars that are available and going to be available in India soon. So electric cars can be broadly classified into low speed electric vehicles and high speed electric vehicles, and or we can say it as low voltage drivetrain electric vehicles and high voltage drivetrain electric vehicles. Low voltage drivetrain electric vehicles are, for example, Mahindra E2O, Mahindra E2O Plus, Miani Reva. Those things used to be in sale in India. They are low speed electric vehicles, or we can say low voltage drivetrain electric vehicles. Also, the cars that are still in sale, like e-Verito, Tata Tigor EV, are also low voltage electric vehicles or low voltage drivetrain electric vehicles. These electric vehicles usually have a battery and a drivetrain of voltage 48 volt to 72 volt. For example, E2O Plus is P6 and P4 use 48 volt system, and P8 and P2 use 72 volt system. Just like that, even e-Verito, Mahindra e-Verito, uses 72 volt system. These 48 volt and 72 volt EVs often usually use lithium ion phosphate batteries. And the car, let's see high voltage EVs. High voltage EVs that are currently in sale, the only EV that is currently being sold that is high voltage drivetrain is Hyundai Kona, that uses a 363 volt electric drivetrain system consisting of lithium ion batteries. Those are made by LG, and also they have active thermal management also. We'll talk about thermal management of lithium batteries in a separate video. Today I will just talk about the classifications, the broad classifications of electric vehicles that are available and going to be available in India. Okay, and the cars that are soon to be launched, the MG ZS EV and Nissan EV, both use high voltage system. The MG ZS EV actually has a very high voltage system of 420 volt to be exact, 454 volt when fully charged. They use lithium ion battery that are being supplied by CATL. They are actually manufactured by CATL at SAIC Automobile factory in China. CATL stands for China Aviation Lithium Batteries, China Aviation Lithium Technologies. And Nissan EV uses 320 volt lithium ion battery pack and a 320 volt system. It seems both MG ZS and Nissan EV both use active thermal management, liquid cooling for their battery packs. So in short, these electric vehicles are broadly classified as low and medium speed or low and medium voltage electric vehicles and high voltage electric vehicles. There are a lot of advantages and disadvantages among this, but mostly low voltage systems, as we all know, low voltage DC systems will have high losses and they have huge current flow between the battery and among the cells and everything. And low voltage systems may be easier to manage and are mostly user serviceable. High voltage system, some precautions and safety measures have to be taken while handling high voltage systems, like 300 volts and 400 volts DC. And so on the whole, these are the two major classifications of electric cars that are going to be already available and going to be available in India. And I also forgot to mention the Tata Tigor EV, both the new version which uses 21 kilowatt hour battery, as well as they used to sell this to ESL, this 16 kilowatt hour version. Both are 72 volt system only. Hopefully this, I think this EKUV100 may also use a 72 volt system that is similar to Mahindra E-Verito. So yeah, that's all the information I have today. In the next video, we will talk more about lithium battery, thermal management and all these things. Okay guys, if you have any comments, if you like this video, if you don't like this video, please put a comment, and if please like the video, please subscribe, and try to press the bell button if you think you like these videos. Okay guys, thank you.